In the last program, we did multiplication of two 16-bit number. Now, today's class, I'm going to multiply two 32-bit numbers. So for that, you have to delete the old file. So select that file and press delete button or right click and remove that file. So it will ask, are you sure to remove this file? Yes. So now, again, I right click there. Then add new item to group. Click ASM file. Now I am typing the name as add multiply 32-bit numbers dot s. So this program is going to multiply two 32-bit numbers. So I already copied the program. So I'm leaving the space. So after pasting, there is no space. So leave first press tab button so that space will be there in the beginning. So again, it is a multiplication of 32-bit. You can write name as 32-bit. Next is export underscore underscore main. The underscore underscore main LDR num1, LDR num, LDR r1 num2. These are the instructions. Actually, num1 and num2 are actually declared in the beginning, in the end. Or if you want, you can declare in the beginning only. So I can declare in the beginning only, or I can declare in the read write area also, because in this area you can do read as well as write, but in the code area you can do only read option. So this is a num1 and num2. They are declared like in the previous program, they are declared in the beginning only. So labels, variables, you have to start without any space in the beginning. So num1 and num2 declared without any space in the beginning. Underscore underscore, two times underscore is there here. Main is a label of our program. So LDR R0 num1 means num1 will be loaded with or num1 value, that is 5555. So you can give ampersand 5555, or you can type 0x, that is hexadecimal. Okay, both are correct. Ampersand 5555555 or 0x. So now R0 is loaded with num1, R1 is loaded with num2. For multiplication of 32-bit number, you have to give two destination register. So instruction for that is UML. U stands for unsigned. MULL means multiplication. Okay. So now if I type here only MUL, see, it is coming in black color. That means it is not a instruction, valid instruction. Only all the instructions you can see, they're coming in blue color. So UML is not there, MUL is there. That is for 16-bit multiplication. For unsigned multiplication, UMULL. One more L I have to put here. So now it is a valid instruction. It's coming in blue color. So since we are multiplying 32-bit numbers, which are present in R0 and R1, so we require multiplication of two 32-bit numbers are 64. So the lower part and upper part will be there. Lower part will contain 32-bit number, upper part will contain 32-bit. So we have two destination registers. Okay, R4 and R3 are the destination registers. Actually, that once you execute UML, R4, R3, R1, R0, R1 and R0 will be multiplied. Result will be 64-bit. The lower part is going to store it in R4 and upper part will be in R3. So given the instruction, we have to declare lower 32-bit and upper 32 in the area product, and it is declared as a data area and it is a read write area, so that you can do a write operation in lower 32 and upper 32-bit constant value. Initially we declared lower 32 and upper 32 as a defined constant data and initially with zero values. After this UML R4, R3, R1, R0, R4 and R3 will have that product. So you have to move that lower 32-bit into lower 32-bit variable location and upper part present in R3 to upper 32-bit to this upper 32 variable location. So now the program is over, so I will compile it. It's giving zero errors. It's giving zero errors. So start debugging. click debug button. Okay, once you start debug, I already told the control will go to in the startup file. It will go to line number 131. We already commented line number 127, 129, and 130. So they are commented. Now the control is at, you can observe this arrow mark. It is LDR R0 underscore underscore main. So it will fetch the address of underscore underscore label and it will load into R0. After loading into R0, click F10. So it will branch to that address. So it will come to our program. So it came to here. This is a multiplication of 32-bit numbers program. So you can observe register in the left side register window. First you click one time step over. So R0 is loaded with num1, which is 55555, 8 times 5. You can give any data you want, num1 and num2. You can give any 32-bit value. So these are 32-bit value because they are represented as hexadecimal value. If you want 32-bit exactly binary bits, so you have to split this 5555 extra digit into binary. For example, 15 is 0101. So like that, 8 times you have to write 0101 like that, okay? Similarly, num2 is hexadecimal 88888. So split that 8 into 4. You will understand why it is 32-bit. So 8, one single extra digit 8 is, in binary it is 1000. Okay. So I am multiplying this 5555555 into 888888. You can give any data whatever you want. You can give smaller number also. But upper bit you have to give it as a zeros. So now the control is here. Next instruction is LDR R1 comma num2. So after this execution, you can observe the content of R2 register. It is 8888. R1 is now 8888 because LDR R1 comma num2. Num1 is loaded to R1, num2 is loaded in R1. So after that, unsigned multiplication of R1 and R0, result will be stored in 2 register because R0, R1 are 32-bit. Result will be 64-bit, double of it. So one register is not sufficient, so you have to provide 2 registers. So you can give any registers. So I'm giving R4 and R3. R3 will store upper 32-bit, R4 will store lower 32-bit. You can check out. Okay, I'm giving next instruction. So you can observe here R3 and R4. So I will verify whether our answer is correct or not. I'll take a calculator. I am in X mode. Okay. So I will type 5555 multiplied by 8888 is equal to, you can see the answer. It is 2D82D82D. So this is upper 32-bit, 27D27D28. It is lower 32-bit. You can see here. R3 is 2D82. That means in R3 we have upper 32-bit, and in R4 we have lower 32-bit. R3 upper 32-bit, R4 lower 32-bit. So LDR R7 next instruction, you have to load R7 the address of 32-bit, lower 32-bit. And we have to store the R4 which is having lower 32-bit, and you have to store into that lower 32 position. See, you can see R4 is having 27D28. You can see here also 27D27D28 in calculator, lower 32-bit. Okay, that is actually present in R4. So next instruction is LDR R7. You have to get the address of lower 32-bit variable. So LDR R7 is equal to is there. So that address came here, which is 0x1 followed by 7 zeros. So I already opened in the previous program only memory window, and by default now it is showing the previous location 10000 only. So now next instruction is store R4 into that location. So first it will store that value here. See, first it is storing lower part. Lower 32 bit are stored in the location. After that, get address of upper 32 bit location into R8. So that is 1004. So this location is okay. This location is actually here we have 4 bytes. 28 is 1 byte, 70 is 1 byte, then D2 is 1 byte, and 27 is 1 byte. So 4 bytes are consumed here. So address of the next location is here. Address of this location is actually 1000004. Address of next one is 10008. Next one is 1000C. So like that, every location we are actually made unsigned long. So it will consume 4 bytes. If you put in character, it will consume 1 byte. So now it is already showing long. So 4 bytes are consumed here. So next we'll start from 0 4 here. Previous location plus 4. So this is 4. This is starting address is 8. So it is coming here 10000004. So in that location, and that means in this next location, it will store the next byte, that is upper byte. So you can see step over and store R3 into that location. So it came, you can observe here, in the next location it came. So whatever answer you are getting here, the first multiplication of 8 times 5 into 8 times 8, that is in hexadecimal. If you multiply, hexadecimal answer is this much. So the lower part of multiplication is coming in first location, that is in 10000. The upper part is actually coming in 10000 fourth location. Okay, thank you.